Hello everyone, in today's video we are going to talk about reproduction in Paramecium caudatum. But before we move on to how reproduction takes place in Paramecium, let's quickly recap ourselves with few basics regarding reproduction. Reproduction is a biological process by which an organism increases its number, and it's of two types. We have asexual reproduction, which involves only one single parent organism, and sexual reproduction, in which two parent organisms are involved. The offsprings, which are a result of asexual reproduction, are very identical to the parent, and in fact, they are copies of the parent, known as clones. So here you can see, this is the parent organism, then this is the offspring, because they are very identical and they are morphologically and genetically similar to the parent organism. In sexual reproduction, on the other hand, the offsprings are different from the parents, yet they share some similar features. So, the best example of sexual reproduction is human beings. Consider yourself. You might have various traits which you share common with your parents. So, for example, your eyes might look like your dad's, or your nose might have the same structure as your mom's. But yet, you have your own different identity. And the reason behind this is actually in the genetic information. Since in asexual reproduction, the DNA comes from a single parent, hence, the individual is very identical to the parent organism. However, in sexual reproduction, the DNA is the combined DNA from two parents. Now, here I have presented for you few ways protozoans reproduce asexually. Now, for those of you who do not know, protozoans are unicellular animals. So, they are primitive animals. There are various methods by which they reproduce asexually, but our major focus in this video is going to be on binary fission, because this is in fact the way by which Paramecium reproduces asexually. But I also want you guys to look at all other ways. We have multiple fission, which is seen in aggregata, budding or multiple budding, which is seen in epholeta, and plasmotomy, which is seen in pleomyxa. So what is binary fission? The word binary fission itself describes its meaning. Bi means two, and fission is a process of splitting. So binary fission means the process of splitting of an organism's body into two halves. And most of the time, these two halves are quite similar to each other. Now here, I want you guys to understand that we're talking about splitting in eukaryotes. That is the cells which have a well-defined nucleus. Now whenever a cell division occurs, there are two steps which are carried out. The first step is karyokinesis, and the second step is cytokinesis. Karyokinesis, if you split the word karyon, means nucleus, and kinesis means division. So it's a division of nucleus. And the other word that I'm talking about, cytokinesis, means the division of cytoplasm. So in a cell, usually what happens is that the nucleus first divides. This is followed by the division of cytoplasm, and this results in the formation of two daughter cells. And this is in fact what happens in binary fission. So here we can see the example of amoeba. In an amoeba, we have a parent cell and we have this nucleus, right? This nucleus is going to undergo karyokinesis. It's going to divide into two nuclei. And this is immediately followed by the division of cytoplasm, and we get two daughter cells. Now here you have to understand the word immediately is very important, because if cytokinesis doesn't follow karyokinesis immediately, then we result in a situation which is known as multiple fission, and we just saw the term multiple fission over here. So multiple fission is actually another form of fission which results in the formation of a multinucleated condition. Now what happens in multinucleated condition is actually that we have a nucleus over here. It will divide once, but instead of being followed by cytokinesis immediately, the nucleus will keep on dividing multiple times, resulting in this multinucleated condition. Eventually, all these multiple nuclei will get surrounded by a little bit of cytoplasm, and this then will be followed by cytokinesis, and then we will get multiple daughter cells. So a very important difference between binary fission and multiple fission is that in binary fission, cytokinesis immediately follows karyokinesis, which is not the situation here in multiple fission. And that is why we get multiple daughter cells in multiple fission, whereas we only get two daughter cells in binary fission. Multiple fission, as I just told you, takes place in aggregata, but a more common example is Plasmodium vivax or the malarial parasite. Now, what are the types of binary fission? Let's quickly go through them. The first type is longitudinal binary fission, in which the cytokinesis occurs along the longitudinal axis or the long axis of the body. So this is the long axis of the body and the cytoplasm will occur across the long axis. Here is the fission point. This occurs in euglena. The second type of binary fission is irregular binary fission, which occurs in organisms which are irregularly shaped, for example, amoeba. And in this, the cytoplasm can split across any plane. The third type of fission is transverse binary fission, in which cytokinesis occurs along the transverse axis. Now, what is this transverse axis? It is the axis which is perpendicular to the longitudinal axis of the body. So if this is the longitudinal axis going like this, then the axis which is perpendicular or at 90 degree angle to it, which is this axis. This is the transverse axis. So here you can see that the split is made upon here. This is the transverse axis of the body. So the transverse binary fission is absolutely important for us because this is the way the paramecium divides. And then we have finally oblique binary fission, in which the cytokinesis occurs along the oblique plane. So it's not definitely 90 degree to the long axis, but it's somewhat oblique. That's why it's called oblique binary fission, and it occurs in ceratium. Now let's quickly go through the steps that happen when a binary fission occurs in paramecium, and it obviously is a transverse type of binary fission because the fission point is transverse. This is the way the binary fission is going to take place. Now let's quickly go through the steps. So the first step, we must familiarize ourselves with a few information that I've already talked about in my previous lectures. The first thing is that paramecium caudatum has two nuclei, and it shows nuclear dimorphism. It has a bigger macronucleus and it has a smaller micronucleus. Also, it shows two contractile vacuoles. We have an anterior contractile vacuole and this is the posterior contractile vacuole. We can know which one is the anterior and posterior one by simply looking at the ends. The blunt is the anterior end while the pointed is the posterior end. So that's quickly, we have went through all of the basic stuff. Now we can proceed with the actual steps, right? So the first step that actually happens is the division of the nuclei and the disappearance of the oral grooves. Now imagine the situation, the organism is trying to divide. So it will try to remove its focus from all of the activities and just focus all its attention on the process of division. So the oral grooves and the buccal structures really start disappearing. And what happens is that the micronucleus divides mitotically while the macronucleus over here divides amitotically. Now, what is the difference between amitosis and mitosis? In simple one-line term, I would just like to say that in amitosis, there is no spindle web formation. And it's very simple. And what happens is that the nucleus really elongates and gets constricted in the middle. That's it. Whereas in the micronucleus, which is dividing mitotically, there is a whole set of mitotic stages that we study. So we know that the first stage is the prophase stage, in which the chromosomes are going to arrange themselves into chromatids. The second stage is the metaphase, in which the chromosomes, which are now arranged as chromatid-like structures, they are going to arrange themselves in the metaphasic plate or the equatorial plate. The third stage is the anaphase, when they will start moving towards the opposite poles. And finally, we have telophase, in which the chromatids have reached the opposite poles, and this leads to a very elongated formation of the micronucleus here, as you can see. And while this is happening, two new oral grooves also form, one in the anterior portion of the body, one in the posterior portion of the body. Now, after the division of nuclei has taken place, it will be followed by constriction in the center of the body over here. This will eventually deepen and it will result in the formation of two daughter paramecia. Also, here you can see that the two new contractile vacuoles are being formed. So, each daughter paramecia is going to have two nuclei and two contractile vacuoles along with one oral groove. Now, the anterior daughter paramecium is known as proter, while the posterior one is known as opisth. Binary fission takes place about 2 to 3 times in a paramecium in a day. And the process of one binary fission lasts for about 30 minutes. So you can see how quick the process is and how quickly it will result in the formation of new individuals. And it will result in quick expansion of the population. However, all the daughter individuals are going to look exactly like the parent organism. Why? Because they share the exact same DNA as the parent organism. This sums up our video for transverse binary fission or asexual reproduction in Paramecium caudatum.